Good morning. Eleanor Roosevelt once said, "A woman is like a tea bag. You only know her strength until you put in hot water." Now you might be thinking, is that feminism thing again, right? Yes, it's the forbidden word, or the hef word. You see, feminism is not Voldemort that you just pretend that does not exist. No, I'm Harry Potter to just rebel against that. I'm just a typical teenage girl who wants to live life to the fullest and push all the boundaries of life. See, now don't put me here with feminazi. I do not hate men, and I do not believe men and women are totally equal, and I like women. Nor I don't like those stereotypical feminazis you see here, like those curly-haired women with horns and spectacles, have those huge nose rings that's just so awkward to watch. Maybe that's why I'm just so jealous of men around me, who can get away from everything. You can wear what you like, not get self-shamed. You can talk loudly, or you can sit how you like and not get termed cultureless and gatless. Moreover, you can walk at night and not get raped. You're a feminist, right? That is every guy after an argument. As if a girl with her own opinions and views is wrong. As if that's feminism, that's a bad thing. See, I don't want to get ashamed that I'm a girl. I don't want to get paid less just because I'm a woman. Nor I want to be used as an object of pleasure if that pleasure is not mutual. See, now, talking about daily life sexism, there was this Bible matrimonial ad. It said that a 37-year-old man wanted a 26-year-old girl who is attractive and cooks food very well. Right now, this sounds more like serving sad rather than an actual wife, except for working children. Then that word, non-feminist, popped up. What do you mean by non-feminist? A girl with no opinions. A girl who will not do anything that her husband says. Get hurt and not fight back. A girl who would be ready to be sold out to anybody. This guy might boast about self-respect for the whole life and marriage, but will lose that while taking dowry. You see, women's safety is a joke right now. They see our clothes provoke them, where their stupidity must provoke us to punch them in the face. They say she wore no clothes, that's why they raped her. Well, it's just like saying, I'll hit you in the head because you wear a helmet. See, you don't show that you are a man by raping her. You show that you're a man and you control your urge. And you provoke, you control your urge to rape her. That is when you become a man. They say that this hashtag Me Too is threatening men around the world. They can't do anything because women might just post anything about them. A girl's life is more threatening than that because the attack can come from any side. See, I think even if I wore a sari or a kurta or even an astronaut suit, I think I could be free because the society considers rape as the woman's fault. Well, her fault was that she was a woman. Nothing else. Dear men, serve your women right. Treat her right. That's all you have to do. Treat her as an individual, not as property. Give her respect. She is your better. She's your half. She's your other half, not a subordinate. And my dear girls, you're beautiful. You're strong. You're amazing people. You don't have to be someone else to be fit into the society. You can be yourself. You don't have to be feminine or you don't have to be manly. You are yourself. You don't have to strip down your femininity. You're not Cersei Lannister from Game of Thrones. Just cut your hair in the middle of the season just to show that you are a serious person. You show your character by your you. mother, you're a sister, and you deserve infinity. I'm just sad that I have to speak about feminism and argue about it with men when I'm coming from a country where you worship women, where you respect women, and ancestors consider women as God. It's just sickening. But now I would like to end by saying a Sanskrit saying. Where you worship women, there goddesses are born.